Thank you. And thank you, the organizer, for giving me a chance to talk here. So let's start my talk. My talk is concerned with inverse obstacle problems governed by partial differential equations. So this is abstract. My theorem is inverse obstacle problems using waves governed by wave equations over a finite time interval. The problem discussed here concerned with detection and range estimation of an unknown obstacle embedded in a general lack background medium or placed behind a known impenetrable obstacle. Impenetrable means wave cannot enter inside. And the final purpose of this talk is to show that the time domain enclosure method introduced by myself and developed by Ito and Kawashita enabled us to know whether the obstacle exists or not by using a single wave over finite time interval on an open ball where the wave is generated. And not only existence, but also if the obstacle exists, the method gives also information about the Euclidean distance, Euclidean, the distance from the observer to an obstacle. This is one addition. So this is the structure of my talk. First, we introduce two problems. One is detecting an obstacle embedded in a lack background media. And the second, detecting an obstacle behind the impenetrable obstacle. And these two sections, we enter into the detail of the description of the two problems and the main result and the outline proof and some remarks. This is the structure of my talk. First introduction. First part of this talk is concerned with through wall imaging via wave phenomena in time domain. Assume that there is a large wall between an observer and an unknown object. And the wall has a very complicated structure. And in addition, the wall is not transparent, opaque. We cannot see directly. And thus the observer cannot see object directly by using visible ray. How can the observer find the object? In particular, we are interested in the case the object is silent, never makes some signal, by himself. So it means acoustically or electromagnetically, and not moving. Maybe dead or something. This is not a place I'm laughing. Yeah, sorry. This one. We use, in future, we want to use electromagnetic wave. So we assume that the wall is electromagnetically penetrable. It means electromagnetic wave can penetrate through wall and generate the electromagnetic wave as a place where the observer is. Yeah. Generate electromagnetic wave. Send. And observe the wave at the same place over a finite time interval. The observed wave should include information about the unknown object. Shiva. Behind the several worlds or embedded in a complicated medium. So free space assumption, that is wave go straight, no longer apply after the electromagnetic waves propagate through the walls. So how can one extract the information from the observed wave? So this is a typical problem in slow-wall imaging. So like this one. Here observer, a very complicated structure. And here, an observer, D is embedded. Okay? And we assume electromagnetic wave propagates through this complicated structure. And observer, reflected wave. And this means several electromagnetic parameters are discontinuous, this one. Okay.
Here. Is this known, the complex
structure? We assume, in principle. But sometimes we don't need detailed structure of this one. I will make presentation later. So, of course, I saw there are several engineering approaches. They introduce various processing of the reflected signal from the wall, having a spatial geometry, very special, simple geometry, like uniform wall, infinite extended, you know. And process means they distinguish signal from other parts and from some unknown object. But it means they assume some background knowledge, you know. And in the frequency domain, we have the linear sampling method introduced by Colton and Kirsch, 1996. They applied this linear sampling method in a simple geometry assumption of the wall. And they employ the concrete home, the Green's function for the background media. And rigorous analysis, just a experimental, numerical experiment, simulation, you know. However, their paper based on the PD structure, governing equation of the wave is used. So this should be belong to a PD based approach. But they never use PD that governs the wave, you know? Just a real data, you know. And for survey, we can point out, for example, this paper, Baranovsky, slow wall imaging, historical perspective, and future direction. There are several engineering approaches. So our approach, the purpose is to develop a mathematical method for slow wall imaging based on the governing equation of the wave in time domain from the beginning to end, rigorously. Of course, the original governing equation should be the Maxwell system in time domain. But as a first step, we consider a scalar wave equation in time domain, simple model. So, another problem B, detecting an obstacle behind an impenetrable obstacle. This one. Develop a mathematical method of imaging an unknown obstacle behind a non-impenetrable obstacle. From a single wave generated and observed at the same place, where one cannot see the unknown obstacle by using visible wave. Of course, if we can see visible, no, nothing to do, okay? Behind is point, like this one. We can see this one because of the existence of diesel. Diesel is called occlusion in this research, in our context. So produce wave, then wave will propagate behind and produce some reflected catch. How? And this also important case. This is corner. These are known obstacles. This is unknown obstacle. Here we cannot see this one. Produce wave, but here is no reflector. So we have to use diffraction effect of wave. Fortunately, I could find some of experimental studies from engineers' side. It's coming from robotics for object tracking. So we are tracing some object, but the object becomes behind some obstacle. So how one can detect the position? Ranging. This paper in Japanese, Niwa, Ogata, Komatani, and Okuno. Title is just for us, suitable for us. Detection and range finder of intercepted object by age-based method. Now, age means acoustic holography. Mathematically, it means, I think, it's analytic continuation. From the obtained data, we reconstruct some acoustic field near obstacle. You know. So then we can make strong the received signal from behind. You know. But it's a very difficult approach, I think. And this is also an English version of their presentation, 2007. So not so old. What they did? They considered the detection problem of unknown object behind another object. Occlusion, as called by them, motivated in robotics for object tracking. They made use of audible sound. So possible to hear. Generated by a speaker. As a way, and catches the reflected sound by microphones placed where the object is line of sight. You cannot see by using visible light. Okay. They found that it is possible to give some estimate of the distance. It means distance, Euclidean distance, to the object using the observed wave. Observed data when the object and occlusion consists of two plates or two balls, very simple geometry, okay? In a simple configuration. Yeah. But they never made use of governing equation PD. So, what can one say by using PD? So this is so. And in this talk, we formulate the problem as an inverse problem for the wave equation. See? So let's enter the detail of problem A. So we model the governing equation of the wave is this one. Alpha x dt square u minus Laplacian u equals 0. The whole space. And some initial data. We put here initial data. This generates a wave. Okay. Where observation time t is finite to be determined later, almost best possible. Okay. Some explicit part. And alpha. To consider general background media, we assume alpha. Alpha is not a general background. Alpha is media which we want to probe. You know? Alpha belongs to L infinity and has lower essential bound. You know? And for simple history, we choose fx is a characteristic function of B. to consider in the usual function spaces, in the subgraph space, where chi b denotes the characteristic function of an open ball b with very small radius. Very small. And here assumption, basic assumption. alpha x takes two forms. Outside of D, alpha 0x. Inside D, alpha 0x plus hx. D is a bounded open subset of R3 with Lipschitz boundary. And alpha 0 is a background medium. Just belongs to L infinity. So possible, very complicated. Okay? And satisfies lower estimate and upper bound. And H is a perturbation of alpha 0x. This expresses the property of D, acoustic property of D. H satisfies one of two conditions. Alpha is greater than alpha 0 or alpha is less than alpha 0. That means this one. Okay? H is positive or negative. And AEX in D. Of course, this part can be reduxive. Only near tubular neighborhood of D possible. Okay? And B in chi BX satisfies this disjoint condition, of course. Because B is a place where the wave is generated. Right. So problem A. Fix T to be determined later, and B. B also fits. And assume that here alpha 0 is known. Question. Can one know the existence of D by observing UXT given at all XT? No? This is the first one. And if possible, extract the information about the geometry of D together with the property of H. For example, H is positive or negative. From the backscattering data, UXT given at all XT. This is our problem. So under the condition T is fixed and fixed B, what information can one extract from the data? If this is possible, then moving B little bit someplace, we can obtain several more detailed information. You know? So this is the first important problem. We apply a method, the time domain enclosure method, introduced in 2007 by myself and collaborator Kawashita and Ito. Okay? This method enables us from data some domain that enclose some unknown. Its origin goes back to the original enclosure method introduced in 1999 and 2000 by myself. And here my collaborator and other groups who considered some variants of enclosure method, several. And here, Kao, I think in China, they used this idea to electrical capacitance homology and applied, they tested using real data also. And one of the, of course, this is one of the direct non-iterative methods based on PD or inverse obstacle. Others, we can say the linear sampling method, Colton-Kirsch, the factorization method, Kirsch, the probe method, introduced by Ikehata, and the singular sources method, Potthast, and recently the monotonicity method, by its origin was introduced by Tamburino and Lubinacki, and Bastian Haraha and Yuhi gave a rigorous justification this method. And related to this continuous lectures given by Daniel, Professor Daniel. I want to point out that the Frog method also makes use of the Runge approximation property. It's base Runge approximation property. And using Runge approximation property, we can give, for example, some harmonic function. That harmonic function blows up on even some curve. Not nodal set, blow up set. We can realize. Okay, this position. And survey on the time domain enclosure method, you can see at this time. And this today's problem, we present the result from this one. This has already published in 2000. So main result, let you solve. We produce direct proof data and define simple this indicator function where W is finite transform, finite Laplace transform books this one, U, here U, this one, and W minus V and alpha 0 on B. Here V. V is a unique weak solution of this one. Laplacian V minus alpha 0 x tau square V. Alpha 0 x chi V x equals 1. This is the inhomogeneous term. So, of course, we can solve this one. So, put here. And just construct this function. Then, the asymptotic behavior of this function is some information. This is my first setup. My divide. Distance, Euclidean distance, D and B, this one. If D is not empty set, then we have, if D is empty set, and T, or positive number, then this indicator function tends to zero. Decaying order is tau inverse. Okay. And here, if D is not empty, and alpha is greater than alpha 0 in the previous meaning, and T is greater than this some quantity, then indicator function becomes minus infinity. This is exponentially minus infinity. And if alpha is less than alpha 0, and T is greater than this quantity, then this quantity becomes infinity, plus infinity. So, this behavior affects the property of unknown obstacle. So, we can distinguish. Yes. And by this behavior, asymptotic behavior, we can know these exist or not. Under assumption, you know, if these exist, this under this assumption. Okay. Moreover, if D satisfies this condition or this condition. Then for all T, we have lower estimate of distance from known quantity. And upper estimate of distance from this known quantity. No, minus, put here minus. Then upper estimate. This gives lower estimate. So this is a range estimation from the observer. Here and here, there should be something, range estimation. And this is a detection and extraction property of unknowns. So just one observed wave contains this information. So moving B some place, then we will get more ranging. Okay? We don't need at the same time take many data, just one data, and finally unify data. Remarks, let P and A denote the center and radius of V respectively. We have distance dV1. This is distance from P to dD minus radius theta. So knowing this distance is equivalent to this one. Thus, from the observed wave, we obtain the upper and lower estimation of the sphere centered at P, whose exterior encloses the unknown object. So this should be belong to enclosure method. And Selim first suggests a new direction of the enclosure method in the case when the background medium is inhomogeneous and quite complicated. Maybe we should give up to find a precise quantity in the observation data, which relates the exact location of unknown obstacles. Instead, give lower and upper estimates rigorously. This is important part. Rigorously for distance ranging. And moreover, if we have a priori information, unknown object at most of this area. So this is a priori information. Then we can know the waiting time for collecting the observation data in advance. We should not wait until that. No. We can know at least some of this time. Then we should not take data more. Just here, stop. Another application, here. Here we show that sometimes we don't need the detail of alpha zero. Okay. Let we solve alpha zero with alpha zero, this same initial data, free space. And define another indicator function, W minus V dash, and alpha zero. Where W is the original observation data, and V is a, it means simulated observation data. Then we can know that theorem first remains valid if IB is replaced with IB dash, B dash. So V is replaced with the solution in time domain. You know, V dash is V is time domain. Okay? So this means we can use this as a monitoring of some area. No. Assume that alpha 0, alpha equal to A on B. This is simple, not so serious assumption. And let T be a large positive number. For example, we are watching some places on 2017-21, send a wave in the medium, alpha equal alpha 0. Alpha 0 means a medium on this data. No? And measure U equal U0 on B over 0T. And you see, between 1 and 6, 5 days, someone entered, someone put something. Then send a wave in medium at the same position. Then medium, of course, changes alpha 1. Then our theorem says the asymptotic behavior of the indicator function tells us a deviation of alpha 1 from alpha 0 without knowing alpha j outside p. If we use both real data, for example, one day, and this is my room, my research room. But then I send some, I did sensing. And some days, someone put here. But I can see where, so send again. Then we find something, existence, and property of this one. We don't mind this detail. This one. If our result can be applied for the wave governed by Maxwell system. Okay. So, outline of the proof. Proof is very simple. We have two lower and upper bound in terms of V and the deviation, you know, modulo this quantity. A sketch of the proof is the following. セット、ディビエーション、W マイナス V。And, まあ、some remainder term. And, this contains tau, so this has a bound tau. Then, from the governing equation of V and W in the Laplace transform domain with remainder term, remainder inhomogeneous term. We have this integration by parts yields this simple identity integral. Here exponential growing, decay. And this part R and V, the estimation of these problem. However, V satisfies this and H1, so easy to this estimate, global estimate, okay? Like resolvent. But using integration bucket, we can easily put. And we rewrite A as this one. This is a completion of square root, completion of square. Square, square. This is, from this, we can easily use this. Just, you see, this part already has an estimate. This has already estimate. This also has an estimate. So, from this one, we can put this one. So, we have. R also has this estimate. And thus A becomes this one. But alpha 0 equal alpha on the support of F, so this vanish. And this becomes alpha 0, so we obtain, omitting this part, we omitting this part. This means this term is minus constant tau inverse in minus tau. Okay? So this is lower estimate. Upper estimate is more technical, this one. And using another integral identity, we have also this one. This coefficient 1 is very important, not constant. 1, very important. We can obtain this one. Then A yields, let's see, because we have this one, A はどれだ？あれ？なんだ？これか。あ、いやいや。This is A. And this has a upper bound. See? Here. This part. So, we obtain this part. Rewriting this, we obtain desired upper bound. So, what is another integral identity? Quite technical than we can obtain another one, this one, this one. And this is original A, first identity, this one. So making use of two identities, we obtain desired estimate, both from below, from upper. Simple integration bypass argument, or multiplier. Thus, everything is reduced to the studying the leading profile of V on D. Yeah, it's easy. We have a comparison principle. You know? Alpha 0 has a upper bound M0 square, and lower bound M0 square. So we can give this estimate, lower and upper. No. So everything reduces to this Laplace type integral. And minimum distance gives a leading profile between D and B. Minimum gives by the Laplace method in a simple case. So this is further remarks of problem A. If alpha zero is a piecewise constant, simple geometry, we can give positive result in one space method. And in three space dimension case, for the signal governed by the equation, this case, with a colored means a command, some command. Piecewise constant background, we have a positive result. This has been submitted some job. And this is a conjecture. Another assumption, alpha 0, LV infinity, shows that this is equal to the first arrival time of the signal governed by this one, started from dB at t equals arrival at t. Of course, we have to formulate the first arrival time of the signal governed by this equation in the case of this one. So maybe we should choose another definition of the distance. Okay. This remains open. Next one, on problem B. This is taken from this paper. This is widely open. Please give positive or negative comment on this article. If something longer. An obstacle D behind the non-obstacle D0. D and D0 bounded open subset was. Here we have to assume C2 by some technical means. And disjoint and connected condition. And T to be determined. This is also important part. And new is the outward normal to both D0 and D0 here. Okay? The governing equation, this one. D0D. Neumann, we consider sound hard obstacle. So impenetrable. And here, from a technical reason, we assume more detail of F. Eta minus X minus P square GX XB. Outside zero. G is a C2 and a positive lower bound. And P and eta the center and the radius of B. So this vanishes on the boundary of B. You know? However, F belongs to H2. This is important for our technical reason. Support FB. So problem similar to before, to be determined. Assume that D0 is known. Can one know the existence of D by observing US given at all? Similar. And if possible, extract the information about the geometry of D from the data. So, this is some rock and wave coming here. Then, wave almost, in this case, coming wave, plane wave, but diffractive inside, you know, here, makes some heat. And if we put here another rock, maybe that produce some wave here. But we have to catch it. We have to catch the reflective here, you know. Yeah. And this will be quite a weak wave. So main result. Define another indicator function, more similar. W equal to this one. And V is a unique solution of this Neumann problem. On D0, outside D0. Okay? So we assume background knowledge, D0. F is coming from initial data of U. Okay. This problem has a source on B. So we can expect that V will decay, exponential decay from source. Very weak. So this is our theorem. If D is an empty set, then for all T we have, of course, this decays tau inverse as tau tends to infinity, or tau inverse. And this is another assumption. Assume that there is an open ball W, such that the closure of D is contained in W, and B join D outside of ball. Assume that D is not empty and satisfies M is greater than distance CB for a positive number M and fix T greater than 2CM with C explicit constant root of square root of 2π. Then we have limit tends to infinity. It means we could detect the existence of obstacle. Moreover, we have this lower estimate of distance dt by divided by this one, the V of time. This is really negative, and from this we obtain a lower estimate of distance dt. So this is ranging estimation. What is W? Meaning this one. W is this is diesel. This is D. Sorry, this is D. This is diesel. Diesel, right? So W is, for example, W, we can take W is minimum ball that contains diesel, you know. So if B and unknown observable D outside of this ball, we can detect with explicit waiting time, T, okay? But unfortunately, if the unknown D is inside this part, then we cannot estimate the time. Of course, we can detect the existence, but we don't know how many long should wait. How many long time we can, we should collect data. This one. And this one. Huh? We'll skip this one. And we can give another condition. If we assume diesel is convex, we can drop the assumption of W, existence of W. But we need some technical condition. This one. D will be a convex, and D is some part behind the diesel, you know. And this one. Then we can use another constant, C alpha. Alpha means this parameter. And the waiting time is this one. Then we can obtain this one. For example, what is the case? This case, huh? The closure of D is W set minus D zero closure in this case. For example, if D zero is ellipsoid, vertically long ellipsoid, then open ball is here. So there is some space here. If D zero, D is inside this some space, but not completely behind, then we can detect the existence. So outline of proof. Outline proof is a mixture of the knowledge from heat equation and wave equation. You know. First, we can easily prove IB tau D has this upper bound and lower bound. This is easy. Where JB tau D equal integral over D of energy. So this proposition says the asymptotic behavior of the indicator function is governed by that of V on D. So this is a result of the combination of the following two factors. First, we can prove this one, asymptotic formula. And we have this one. And using a classical argument of Lux-Phillips, we can prove also this one. E tau is asymptotically JB tau, not O, asymptotically JB tau. So, the leading profile of indicator function is completely governed by this tau. Okay? We can say more if DD is smooth, explicitly. So, from proposition we have, if D equal empty, of course, the tau coming from V disappears, so it becomes this one. And if D is not empty and T satisfies, explain this one, blow up. Then this also blow up. And we have this lower and upper estimate. So everything is reduced to study this one. So unknown D is disappear in the consideration. Just V coming from known D zero and study on unknown obstacle, its behavior. So this, find T as explicit as possible when this appears. This case occurs. And give lower and upper estimate of this one. And we know that if DD is smooth, then this is equal to, equivalent to this one. So everything is reduced studying this property. So here are the core of the proof. We use semi-group theory of given delta heat equation, okay? And construct this function by using very small time Laplace transform. But here, tau square. Then we have this estimate easily. So this property can be extracted from this one, from heat equation. Then here we use Neumann heat kernel estimate. One has the expression ZXT using Neumann heat kernel. See Ohava's book. And this has a lower bound by the comparison of two semigroups, domination of two semigroups property. We have this lower estimate. So ZXT has a lower estimate. So everything reduced to the lower estimate of Dirichlet heat kernel. Here we use some classical result of Vandenberg, 2009, lower estimate of heat kernel by using a geodesic distance. So the point is replace this part with Euclidean distance. The point is. Because we have this one, lower estimate here. So this is not so simple content. So replace with Dirichlet. So this is key lemma. Let U be an open ball, then given XY outside ball, there is some arc gamma in R3 minus U. And length has this bound. This is the origin of constant. This has the upper bound of by using Euclidean distance. Okay? So we can replace this part. This is Gaussian. So this is Laplace transform. So take infinity and plus remainder. We have obtained this usual Laplace type integral. So checking asymptotic behavior, we obtain lower estimate. This is outer limit square. And this part is, we have to use another upper bound. This can be done by using an upper bound of the heat kernel together with space variable derivative. See, we can see it's a corollary of a general theory of Ohava's book. This is a convex case. We also have this. So we obtain. This is a result of the application of the argument of Giria, Sarf, Koste. They showed outside of closed convex obstacle is inner uniform in potential theory. So finally, I want to say extension to the Maxwell system. In the Maxwell system, we assume first this land D perfect conductor body. Then boundary condition becomes this one. We corresponding to V, one should consider the solution of this one. You know? That was clear. And I bet indicator function, the leading part should be this one from this experience in the case of these electrolytes. Because we have also some modification of Lux-Phillips argument in the Maxwell system. So how to study of this one? So along our lines, we have to consider this approach. a possible approach. VXT should asymptotic to this solution coming from heat equation type system. This is coming from initial data. So to obtain lower estimate of V, but this is a vector. So how to do? Unfortunately, I could not see any related result. I have to consider this one. If someone has knowledge about this, please suggest any reference, advice. So, it's all. Thank you.